The numbers, the studies, the first-person stories all paint a very dire picture. The mental health and well-being of university students has deteriorated over the last decade. Today we're talking with Conrad Hogg, a recent graduate from the University of Western Australia, about this troubling trend. He's invested in helping change the student mental health trajectory. As a graduate with honors in medicine, pharmacology, and French, Conrad was also a university representative student who worked tirelessly on campus to increase the voice students have on campus. He's also acutely aware and invested in bringing the change. Let's see if we can get in and start talking with Conrad. All right, looks like we're gonna have Conrad joining us on the line from Perth here in just a moment.
Hello.
Hey,
can
Conrad.
Can you see me? Is it working?
I think we're live. I think we're good. This is excellent. This is the first time for both of us. So yeah, thank you so much for joining us and taking us on this very interesting conversation. I mean, you're a recent graduate, but when I think back to my university days at the University of Utah in Salt Lake City, USA, I remember it as a time of discovery, highlights, finding things out about myself, both in school and sport. But it was also you found yourself in some very stressful situations. As a recent graduate, what was your experience like?
Yeah, definitely. I really loved my time at university. I think all the things you said, it's a great time to learn more about yourself, who you are, what you want to do in life, learn some great skills and make some even better friends along the way. But equally, I think uni can be pretty stressful for most people. I think that's very much the experience here in Australia, and that's what we hear from students all over the world as well. So it's really important for students to look after their health and well-being and make sure that they can bring their best self to uni and make some really good friends along the way.
So when you're talking about health and well-being, I mean, so you're part of the FISU Healthy Campus program, which is directly invested in helping students have really good health and well-being outcomes. But what exactly does this mean? Student health, student well-being.
Yeah, sure thing. So for those that don't know, the FISU Healthy Campus program is all about finding ways for universities to better support the health of everyone at university, especially students. And what this means for me is really looking after all aspects of people's health, whether that's your physical health through being able to access medical services and live a full, healthy life, being able to be physically healthy through eating a balanced diet and getting to enjoy sport with your friends and keep fit, but also your social health, the way that you connect with others, your sexual health, and importantly, your mental health as well, to make sure that you're doing well with all of your mental well-being, and you're really bringing a good mood, a good energy, and your best self to uni every day.
And so, I mean, I came across a stat right before, thinking about our discussion, and it was that 1 in 4 university students are going to experience a mental health crisis in a year. And then on your campus, the University of Western Australia, only 4 out of 10 students said that they rated their mental health as good. So are we in a time when universities are facing a student mental health crisis?
Yeah, I think so. More and more what we see is students really struggling with their mental health at university. The people are both very stressed with workloads and with all of these expectations that are put on them, but increasingly experiencing higher levels of things like feelings of anxiety and depression. And that's really, really troubling. And a really big problem that universities are going to have to tackle to ensure that their students can be safe and well while they study and can really get the best out of their university experience. And it's really sad and heart-wrenching to see firsthand as well so many students struggling to keep doing well at uni.
So for those students listening in, so I mean, you were just a recent graduate in 2018, now gone on to start a really successful start of your professional career. And you you had several majors. I think you were, studied cancer medicine. You were also in pharmacology and a French major as well. So how were you able to, to balance such a demanding demanding academic program, be a student representative, and also look after your own mental health at the same time. What are some tips and tricks for our students out there listening in?
Yeah, definitely. I'm speaking from my personal experience, but for me, it was really important to manage my time well. I think it's really easy to feel overwhelmed with work when you've got so many things going on. My schedule was pretty packed, as many university students' schedules are, with things both inside and outside of uni. So it was really important to me to make sure that not only could I organize my time well, but I could visually see when and where all of the different things I need to do were going to happen. So it felt less overwhelming as well. Other tips and tricks from me is to find ways to be able to balance your mood and get on top of negative feelings when you have them. For me, that's things like going for a run. Sometimes I practice mindfulness. Things like that for me, I found really helpful to not get feelings of being overwhelmed and staying connected with my own health and well-being, as well as connecting with friends and all of those social things, which for a lot of people are really good for their mental health.
Yeah. And so when we talk about some of these stresses that university students are facing on campus, I mean, certainly there's academic stress, but I don't know if that's going to be going away anytime soon, nor maybe do we want it to. But also, I guess there's, you know, lack of resources, sometimes obviously time, but also maybe, you know, money in particular, if you have to start taking out student loans and stuff like that. But there's also lots of different changes going on, relationships, expectations, environments. Take us through what that experience was like for you and what you're seeing as somebody that works in the mental, you know, that is invested in the student health and wellness area, so we can understand what students are going through.
Yeah, sure thing. As you said, I think there's really five big categories. Academic stress, having a lack of access to resources. Yeah, five. changing relationships, changing expectations, and changing environment. And I think most students experience most of these to one degree or another. Academic stress is pretty straightforward to understand. That's things like your course load, being worried about the exams and tests that you're coming up and balancing your time. A lack of resources for a lot of people, though, is about largely financial stress. A lot of students find it really difficult to stay financially afloat and make ends meet while at uni. I know in Australia, 1 in 7 uni students often go without skip meals because they can't afford to pay for food, which is really challenging. And those kind of stresses have a follow-on effect on people's mental health as well. When we talk about changing relationships, environments, and expectations, that's really about this time at university being something new and challenging. So we know that your relationships with your parents, with your peers, maybe hopefully budding romantic relationships for a lot of students, are something which can be quite stressful as they change, particularly for people that are going to uni far away from where their parents live. They might be without that support network for the first time. We also have changing expectations, particularly coming in as a first year. There's all these thoughts about who you have to be. You have to be interested in X, Y, and Z, and who are going to be your new friends, and how are you ever going to get into the profession that you want to, and why aren't you doing as well as your peers? And I think that's really challenging for a lot of people, to that sense of finding yourself and balancing the expectations of others and then finding out what your actual expectations of yourself are. And lastly, the changing environment. You're suddenly put in this new place with no one that you know. You have all these resources that and different activities that you don't quite know how to do. I know when I started uni, I had no idea how to make a proper bibliography and do my referencing, and couldn't seem to find any resources of how to actually do that. And although that's a relatively minor thing, added on top of a lot of things, for some people that can be really stressful and have a big impact. So yeah, it's really those five key classes of stress: academic, resources, relationships, expectations, and environment.
So if we talk about the incoming class that's going to be starting up university here in the fall, and let's take you back to your experience that you had. So, I mean, you came straight from high school, you came into the University of Western Australia, incoming class of 8,000 people. I mean, what was it like to be in this exciting, crazy, awesome time, but also psychosocially stressful environment.
Yeah, super exciting, definitely. Lots of new things to try. I know I got involved in clubs and societies and all of those new fun social things in uni, as well as definitely really loving all of my academic work as well. But I think the stressful things are really finding your new network and of people to hang out with. For me, one of the challenging things is many people that I went to high school with didn't go to the same university as me. And that made it really challenging to find a group of a support network of people at university where we could all look out for each other. And that was, for me, one of the big challenges coming in. But for different people with different circumstances, it can be all range of things. People coming in with different needs or different aspects of their identity that they're struggling with or still trying to work out or potentially feeling isolated or left out because of their identity, whether that be sexuality or gender or race or something else. That can be really challenging for people as well to try and find an environment where they feel like they fit in at university.
So talking about building that network, you mentioned that this, you know, being a student representative, take us through what it was to be part of the student guild and what that brought to you, both, you know, to help you grow as a leader, to help you give a voice to the students, you be part of that voice, but also, I mean, it must have given you a nice community to enjoy the university time with.
Yeah, definitely. Being involved in student advocacy was a really important part of my time at university. For me, issues of academics for students and students getting a fair go, as well as especially student mental health and students being able to cope with increasingly stressful environments at university was something that was really important to advocate for. So a big part of my time in the Guild was finding ways to advocate for students so that we could develop systems to better look out for students. We know that in the last 10 years, student rates of suicide have increased by almost 75%, which is incredibly shocking. It's so scary and sad. So for me, being able to be part of change in those aspects was incredibly important to bring light to those issues and find new ways with university in order to make changes in those areas as well. In terms of in my development as a leader and building a network of like-minded people, it was also essential. We worked really, really closely.
Sorry, I think something just weirdly happened with my app. I've probably been on Instagram for too long on my phone.
No, I think we're all good. I think we just lost you just for 1 second there. You were talking, I think, about really the stress that students had on, you know, on the campus, and maybe something about, you know, when they're really pushed to the edge then of that experience.
Yeah.
You made a reference about 2007 to 2017, which is a statistic that I found really shocking, that you said there's been an increase in suicide rate among university students of 75%. So, I mean, my question is this, we can't accept this. I mean, this is something that this really seems like a crisis that we're having. What were you doing within the Guild as a student representative to help, you know, to help students in that might be going through a particularly challenging time and to help them get through that?
Yeah, definitely. We were primarily trying to make a difference in this important issue in two ways. Firstly, by advocating to change the way that the university treats the issue, and by bringing light to the issue through advocacy. And secondly, by providing students with support and awareness and information through the Guild as well. So we ran services and gave students information about how they could better look out for themselves with our team of counsellors. And that was something that we thought was really important to do to help students to find support, as well as doing the first thing I mentioned, which is advocating for larger scale change, both in the way that the university administers health services, but also in the way that university environments are structured to decrease the amount of stresses that students are exposed to.
All right, so we got to reduce the stresses, we got to reduce the impact of the stresses, and then we got to tackle the aftermath when that comes around. What were a couple of ways that you guys would deal, you know, in, let's say, like with that aftermath, maybe in, you know, so that doesn't become a crisis situation for somebody?
Yeah. So when we're talking about intervening to help students before they reach points of crisis, that's largely about teaching people to look, check in with themselves and look after their own mental health, and encourage them to seek help and support, both from their friends and family and teachers, and when needed from health professionals as well. So we're talking about investing in people's health and wellbeing before it gets to a point where they're feeling in a state of crisis and really, really overwhelmed. So yeah, that's all about reducing the impact of the stresses on people by giving them techniques and networks that will help them to deal with the circumstances that they find themselves in.
And so what about those people on campus that are just crushing it? They're living the best lives they've ever had, you know? I mean, like, life is going well. They're doing well in school. They're, you know, doing well in their outdoor, their pursuits outside of the school. That, you know, it's just, like, they're just truly blossoming. Why should they care about, you know, health, wellness, well-being? Because it looks like they got everything figured out.
Yeah, I think sometimes it really appears that way. At least in my experience, a lot of people that appear like they're crushing it and the world is at their feet and they're just doing life really well. Within themselves, they might be struggling with something still. So for them as well, it's really important to check in with themselves and to take care of their own mental health and well-being, to make sure that they're doing well as well. Because distribution of things like mental illness and poor mental well-being isn't necessarily distributed just to people that don't have that appear to not to be really struggling. Sometimes people can appear to be doing fine, but on the inside, really struggling. If people really are crushing it in every way possible, have great mental health, well, then I think it's really up to them to see how they can support others as well. I think we all have a role to do in building a supportive community that cares for everyone at universities, about making an environment that's accepting and that genuinely cherishes people and wants them to succeed psycho-emotionally and academically. I think it's up to all of us to help to foster that environment, particularly those who are doing really well with their own mental health.
Yeah, I think that's a great point you make. And so when you were working as a student representative, what are you most proud of your team that you guys collectively were able to do to bring to the University of Western Australia's campus for the students?
Yeah, a few things. I think there's some stuff we're really proud of quite tactical things about academic policy and making assessment fairer for students and bringing better services on campus, like food and drink and stuff as well. But in student mental health, which is, I think, probably not as fun and exciting for many people, but probably equally, if not more important, we did a lot of work in coordinating responses across universities in the state that we studied in. Because there really wasn't even a lot of discussion about this issue and thinking about how we could actually respond to it. So we did some work in bringing together all of the key university decision makers so that they could start to talk about this issue and find ways to make universities better environments for students. We also did a lot of work in improving our own service offering so that students could be better supported by the Guild, which it was our organisation at the University of Western Australia, and by giving the university some advice and advocacy in what we thought that they could do better to support students.
And so I've heard something about this, the whole of university approach. What does this mean to have this whole of university approach?
Yeah, definitely. I think the whole of university approach is really about approaching mental health and the well-being of students more generally, not as one specific tactical thing that should be dealt with and then left alone by potentially a small team of counsellors or professional staff somewhere in the university. It's really about building the university as a system and as a community that looks out for everyone in it and embeds practices that look after people and foster good well-being all across the university's different staff, and student communities and alumni and really everyone that's involved in the campus.
And so Conrad, how do we do this? How do we build this whole of university approach? I mean, you mentioned that you can need to look out for your friends, in particular if you're in a place where you're able to help others. You kind of mentioned something about the breaking down the mental health stigmas, but take us through, I don't know, a three point process of how we can take on plan. This. Yeah, 3-point plan. Yeah, give us the Conrad's 3-point plan. Yeah.
Sure. I think number one is for us to recognize the size and importance of this issue. It really is something that is incredibly challenging for so many people to deal with and has such a profound impact on people and on our communities at universities as well. So recognizing that impact and breaking the stigma around it and starting to talk about it is definitely the first step. I think the second step is creating open lines of communication and working together across the university to find ways to better support everyone that studies and works there, and creating a community atmosphere of people that care about each other and want to do things to help other people as well. And then, of course, the third thing is out of that process, taking initiative. So taking things like something simple like an Are You Okay Day to check in with people, or initiatives to provide better mental health support services or whatever it may be, and really championing those and giving them the time and attention that they deserve and need in order to support students strongly.
And so, you know, both you and the University of Western Australia are part of the FISU Healthy Campus program. The university as a pilot, you as an expert to help give the what students need on campus, what this program can provide to the students. So why are you so interested and invested in being part of the FISU Healthy Campus program?
Yeah, definitely. I think I'm invested in the FISU Healthy Campus program because the FISU Healthy Campus program is invested in the success of students, in helping students to live healthier lives at university, both in staying more physically active, being able to get nutritious food on campus, which they love, being able to look after their own mental and social well-being, and just generally living more full and well lives at university. That's a cause which I definitely want to be a champion of, particularly when it comes to mental health and well-being. So I'm eager to contribute my experiences consulting with students and with the university, and collaborating with other student representatives across the world through some work we did last year in order to bring those views to the fore and make sure that the solutions that FISU is proposing are things which are actually going to be able to make a difference to students. And I think that's what we've done so far.
And finally, I mean, you know, FISU, we're a university sports. I mean, we deal with, you know, education, culture, all that part of it, but sports is really in the core DNA of what we do. And so where do you see sports and the FISU Healthy Campus program and what's going on the University of Western Australia campus?
Yeah, definitely. FISU is really, really important for us at UWA. We're a big sporting campus. We compete in the University Games, which is an Australia-wide competition of universities, and through FISU tournaments across the world as well. And as a student, as an athlete myself, it's something which is really exciting and fun. So FISU is really important in helping us to engage with other athletes across the world, and also through finding ways for people to have more fun doing sport at uni, have better experiences, and hopefully use that to craft a greater sense of well-being at uni as well.
Yeah, perfect. Thank you so much. Any final words before we sign off, Conrad?
No final words from me. I just really thank you for taking the opportunity to talk to me about this important topic today, and encourage everyone listening to take care of themselves and check in with their friends, particularly with all of this challenging time that a lot of people's mental health is facing at the moment, many of us being locked at home to protect our communities from the COVID-19 pandemic. So take care of yourselves, everyone, and be kind to each other.
Thank you so much. Merci beaucoup, Conrad. And I got thrown a little French, right? I mean, you're the major. Yeah. I live in the French-speaking part, and let's just put it this way. I don't got a degree in it. So, thank you so much. And I look forward to really seeing how you and the team of experts are able to bring this FISU Healthy Campus program to the students, making definite, you know, specific impacts on their experience on the campus. So for that, thank you so much. And I look forward to all the work that you and your team does.
Thanks so much, Torin. As they say in Geneva, merci et plus tard.
Au revoir.
Au revoir.